So this is the last video lesson in the measurement and units playlist. This video is over how to conduct mathematical operations using significant figures. And you must know how to determine the number of significant figures before you even attempt to watch this video. Otherwise, it's not going to make any sense to you. So let me give you a little bit of a background first. We're going to first start off by talking about addition and subtracting sig adding and subtracting sig figs. This concept is going to be very, very unusual to you. All the concepts related to mathematical operations are going to be very unusual to you because it doesn't necessarily follow the adding and subtracting and multiplying and dividing rules that you've learned in math class because we are talking about measurements. That's the key thing here. I do not want you to think that your math teachers are teaching you something wrong. I do not want you to think that science is something completely different than math. We are dealing with measurements. When you literally have to add coffee into this coffee cup, Starbucks does not add exactly 350 milliliters to their tall coffee. They just estimate. They pour in about 350 milliliters. This could very well be 349, 348. It could be 351, 352. They do not put an exact amount of coffee. So I have a value here, a measurement of about 350 milliliters of coffee inside of the Starbucks cup. Let's say I like my coffee with creamer. Usually, if you tell them you want creamer in your coffee, they'll give you a little less than what the amount is supposed to be. So let's just say our creamer is about 5 milliliters. Okay, it's about 5 milliliters. Well, when you add the creamer to the coffee, if we're talking about measurements, we still say that the combination is about 350 milliliters. This digit here, this zero, that's an uncertainty. That is an uncertain digit. We are not 100% certain that the exact volume of the coffee plus the creamer is 350. So we're still estimating it's about 350. It could be below, it could be above, but that's the difference between measurements, which have some level of uncertainty, versus actual values in math class when you're adding and subtracting exact numbers. So let me tell you the rules of adding and subtracting measurements. I have an example here of a piece of rope placed against a ruler. So we're going to call this ruler centimeters, even though it's not to scale. If I was going to use my sig fig rules that I learned earlier, when I take the measurement of this rope. I see that the measurement falls between 3 and 4. It's a little bit past the 3.5 mark, but not quite to the 3.6 mark. So I'm going to estimate that the length of this rope is 3.59 centimeters. This last digit is an uncertain digit. It is an estimated digit. So if you think that the rope sits more at 3.58 centimeters, I'm okay with that. It is an estimation. So I'm going to show you another piece of rope against a different ruler, against a less precise ruler. So with this particular ruler and this piece of rope, I have a value, an estimation of a measurement that is between 4 and 5. Don't quite know exactly what it is, but I'm just going to estimate 4 point, it's past the halfway mark. So let's just say 4.8. That's my estimation. I really would like to say something like 4.75. But I don't even know where the 4.7 mark is, so I have to only estimate one digit. This is a lesson we learned a few days ago, so if you're not really familiar with how to properly read equipment, you might want to go come to tutorials or ask a friend or watch someone else's video tutorial. I don't have a video tutorial on that because you need to know how to read equipment for this course. So, I have a piece of rope that's 3.59 centimeters, another piece of rope that's 4.8 centimeters. If I were to add these two values together, my sum can only be as precise as the least precise value. So, if I'm going to add these pieces of ropes together, my sum can only be as precise as the least precise value. So when I add up the ropes together, I have to put it against this ruler here. This ruler was more precise than this. I have to put it against this ruler, and therefore, when I add the numbers together, I end up with 8.3. This is just a conceptual idea of adding, and I'm going to show you how you can accomplish this on paper. So what I like to do is I like to line up my decimal places. If I have 37.24 milliliters and I'm adding it to 10.3 milliliters, I recognize this is the less precise value versus this one, and I have underlined the last significant figure in each of the measurements. Now, in a normal math class, if I were to ask you to add these numbers together, you would get 47.54. But that's not the answer when it comes to reporting a measurement using the correct number of sig figs. What I like to do is I like to circle the column that all the sig figs have in common. I'm going to say that again. I like to circle the column that the sig figs have in common, the sig figs have in common. And so when I am going to take my final answer, I'm going to round it to this place value, to the tenths place in this example, and I report it as 47.5 milliliters. I'm going to report it as 47.5 milliliters. So this is going to be a little tricky because it's not going to be the obvious answer. It's not going to be just add the numbers together and write down what you get. We have to learn how to round it based off of the less precise number. These are the same, the rules for adding and subtracting are the same. Let's take a look at another example. If I have 27.87 grams and I'm subtracting it by 2.2342 grams, this is the normal number you would get. You can stick it in a calculator, you can get the number, and this is the normal value one would get without knowing anything about sig figs and measurements. I've underlined the last significant figure in each of these values, and now I'm going to double check and make sure my decimals lined up. So line up your decimals. I'm trying to line up all the numbers so that it's pretty easy to circle a column. And I'm going to circle the last sig fig column they all have in common. And so here's the column that they all have sig figs in common. And now I'm going to decide, does that three stay a three or does it round up to a four? Since it's sitting next to a 5 or higher, we're going to round that up to a 4. We report this difference as 25.64 grams. We report the difference, the measurement. Remember, these are measurements. These are not just numbers. They have a certain level of uncertainty to them. We're not sure about some of these measurements. So if we're going to subtract them, we have to report our answer based off of the less precise value. So that is how to complete an addition or subtraction problem. This is not in your notes, but I would like for you to just practice them on your own. You can hit pause, keep watching, but I definitely want you to try because remember, practice makes you better. These were intentionally created for whiteboard practice, so you know this is your opportunity to practice before you move on with the PowerPoint. So the column they have in common here would be this tenths place column. And we're going to take this one, we're going to round it up to a two because it's sitting next to a five or higher. If you don't know how to round properly, you might want to go back and watch the first video. Toward the end of the video, I show you how to round numbers to a correct number of sig figs. The first video in my playlist, by the way. This is the answer you would see on a multiple choice test as the correct answer. This is the answer you would see as a distractor answer. Make sure you know the difference. So the sum or difference of an equation should have the same number of digits after the decimal as the value with the least number of digits behind the decimal. Now I'm going to go ahead and give you a warning. We're kind of taking the easier problems that involve decimals when it comes to adding and subtracting. We could actually get some really difficult problems involved with adding and subtracting, but we're going to try to keep it simple, so we're not complicating things. If you do decide to reach out to additional resources to learn about adding and subtracting, using sig figs, you might run into some really, really difficult problems that might confuse you. So I just want to give you that heads up early. Now, when it comes to multiplying and dividing, this is a little bit easier, as long as you know how to tell the number of sig figs. So for multiplying and dividing, what you want to do, you don't need to line it up this way, with the decimal lined up unless you want to. But the first thing you want to do is identify the number of sig figs in each of the values you are multiplying or dividing. This number has 4 sig figs. This number has 2 sig figs. Remember, the zeros in the front are not significant. So multiply the numbers like normal in your calculator, and then make sure you take the lower number of sig figs and round this answer based off of that. So we're going to take this answer, round it to 1, 2 sig figs. We report it as 2.8 centimeters squared. One thing I didn't mention earlier, I'm going to back up just a little bit. When you add and subtract units, only when you add and subtract, they must be the same unit. They must be the same unit. When you multiply and divide units, they multiply and divide just like numbers. Centimeters times centimeters is centimeters squared. And I'll show you other examples of what to do if they're not the same. So this is the correct way you would report a multiplication, of the product of these two numbers. If I had these three numbers that I'm multiplying together, I want to first recognize how many sig figs there are in each value. This one has 2, this one has 4, this one has 2 sig figs. This is the answer you would get in your normal calculator, if you multiplied all three numbers together. And we're going to take this number and round it to the lowest number of sig figs, which is 2. And I count 1, 2, 1, 2. And this 5 rounds up to a 6. But watch out, because we want to make sure to retain the number in the hundreds place, and we get 100, not hundreds place, but we want to make sure that the value is still 100 something, and this is 160. I'm multiplying centimeters times centimeters times centimeters, so that's why it's cubed. Let me give you a quick division problem. Type this into a calculator. Recognize this is 3 sig figs. This is 1 sig fig. So our answer should be just 1 sig fig. When you divide meters divided by meters, they cancel each other out. So this actually has no unit to it. Notice I'm rushing because my computer's about to die. So report it as 1, just 4, 1 sig fig. Try this out. Keep watching to see the answer. Remember, these are all measurements here, even though I accidentally left off units. And finally, here are some practice problems with the answers. Do practice these things so that you can make sure you're doing it right. Keep watching. Well, I guess that's it before my computer dies. If you have any questions, make sure to ask in class and pay close attention to the way the units multiply, divide, and are added and subtracted from each other too.